Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ari, and today we have a new chapter of One Piece. It's chapter 1126. It's called... I lost the page. It's called Taking Responsibility. And the front page is Only Child Yamato and the Holy Inari Shrine Pilgrimage, Volume 14. A local soba shop in Kure is reporting missing girls. So the carpenter guy is missing and the girls are missing. Right. Before we start reading the chapter, last chapter. Oh my god, so much happened. I'm still processing everything. We most likely have Emu's power. It's the devil fruit. I think at least. I've seen a lot of people being... I posted in the subreddit that I think it's a devil fruit, and some people agree, as in other people talk about it. So I think most of us are thinking that Emu's power is the devil fruit. Garling is the new defensive god of the elders. We don't know if he is going to get the same power of Saturn or something new. We have to wait and see. And let's see. Hold on. Let me go to the previous chapter real quick. The vice admirals are aware that Saturn is dead. That's pretty big. The Vegapunks launched this Labostratum up into the air via clouds. I saw someone talking about the clouds might come in. Come in play later with the sea level rising, so maybe certain islands will be lifted up into the air by clouds. We have a massive cloud pirates instead. There's was one more thing. Ivan's son said tequila wolf, vodka wolf, rum wolf, and bourbon wolf. All of them are building those massive bridges that are spanning over 100 years. So someone in the past knew that the sea level would rise, and they started building bridges. Technically a country on a bridge. And there's one in East Blue, West Blue, South Blue, and North Blue. So what if when all the sea level rises, all those bridges are connecting to each other? Sort of like a wrap around the world. Sort of like the red line, but with a bridge. Someone has been thinking really far ahead. Alright, let's start reading the chapter. I'm so excited. Again, taking responsibility. I mean, start with the giants. It was a while after we left you guys at Water 7. Catching up with the giants. We couldn't wait to see the captains again. So we went to Little Garden ourselves. So that's what happened. Luffy's eating a lot of meat. So that's what happened. Anyone be curious after 100 years? when we got there, these two were still going at it barehanded. Gabba-bamba. Huh? How come? Sometimes weapons just break. Yag-yag-yag-yag. There's a big panel. You think a punch is enough to take down this stubborn oof? Oh, there's a new laugh. Da-pa-pa-pa-pa. That's a real problem when you're in a duel to the death. In the end they got us to go back to Elbaf with them. We had to arm ourselves again. We Oimo, Kishi, Dory and Broggy, yeah, all drinking and eating and having fun. All the straw hats are all down on the table, looking super tiny. Of course, because they're giants. You went for new weapons, so you're still fighting? Of course! Nami, I'm done. I'm drinking beer. Come on, Nami! Didn't you learn a thing back in Little Garden? You tell her, Usopp! This is some strong booze. It's called Absinthe! It's called Absinthe, the green fairy. Careful, there's a chance it'll make you hallucinate. Gah, 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 gah. Hold on. Ooh. They're drinking absinthe, that's insane. And then we just have a few panels of everyone partying. Liff is still eating. Brooke is playing music. Jimbe laughing. Usopp and Sanji hugging each other and dancing around. Lilith and Robin just nibbling on food. No, Robin's actually holding a massive piece of meat, I think, and peeling up from it. You're going frunking on super! Oh! Whoa! There's a panel here and Zoro is laughing, he's smiling. That doesn't happen often after the timescape. I like that. Then we have Tiny Bonnie and Kuma. We finally got to reach it together. The horizon. And Kuma just sitting there holding Bonnie, and there's just the mouth is just one line, but you can sort of see a smile in it. I don't know if he's still conscious or what his deal is. Alright. And then we jump to an incident occurred just over a month ago here at Gartel Island in the New World. Gartel. The pirate Bartolomeo the Cannibal entered Empress Redhead Shang's territory and burned the city's flag, a blatant affront to the Emperor. That's what Shanks and the crew talked about earlier when they were in Wano. That Barto had burned down their flag and replaced it with Luffy's flag. Ah! Then they jump to the next panel and Barto is sitting on his knee, hands on his back, and Shanks is right in front of him. Many crews and islands rely on my flag. If I just let this slide, people would lose faith in it. And my friends and allies will become targets. You're absolutely right. Please, Barto is putting his head on the ground and he's bruised up and blood spitting out from his mouth and his eyes, and he's going, please forgive us. We weren't thinking. It was a foolish mistake. And all the people in the city just looking at the situation. Wow. And then there's Shanks just pale. There's nothing in the panel, just Shanks standing there and he's pale, going on. I can't do it, but he's just looking at him. This is a deadly poison. See to it that Straw Hat Luffy takes this within a month. What? It causes intense pain. Blood erupts from the victims till they finally die. We can overlook this if your boss takes responsibility. There's no way we could do that to Luffy Senpai. What is happening? Barto is just biting down on the bottle and going up and drinking it. What? Boss! Stop us! You're gonna die! He's gonna go. It'll make you and your blood spurt out. That's fine by me. Luffy Senpai never asked us to share that sake or take up his flag. I ain't gonna get him involved in my mess. His time is too precious to waste on someone like me. I'm good being just another scrub who got killed trying to show up an emperor. Aw, man. I wish I could have seen Luffy Senpai become the Pirate King. Damn it all! I threw that chance away like an idiot. It's up to you guys now. Ukashira! See you around, guys. And he goes, burp. Just a question mark above his head. Whoa, they just left us be? Let's get as far away as possible. Looks like the poison was a fake. It would never hurt Luffy Senpai at all. I thought the emperors were meant to be ruthless. He was softer than I expected. Oh, I forgot Shanks' crewmates. Oh my god. Possible. Shanks' crew. I should know his name. Oh my god. Crew members. Ben. So sorry. Ben Backman going. What are you smirking about? Isn't it hard not to smile? He's so dedicated to Luffy. Just smiling. Hey boss, mind stepping out of the way? We still gotta teach him a lesson. And Yasop is pointing his gun. On this day, Bagartle Island, the Barter Club pirate ship was sunk. There's a massive explosion out in the sea. What the hell did Yasop shoot? It is unknown if they are if there are any survivors. Holy shit. Pirate Island. How the hell did I let this happen, Pizarro? I haven't been gone that long. It's not that simple, yeah. Pizarro is the one with the island fruit, so he's basically the entire island. Didn't you hear? The world is on the brink. The poneglyphs ain't an obscure secret anymore. We emperors are gonna have to... This is Teach talking to Pizarro, by the way. We emperors are gonna have to tear each other to pieces over them. You think the government and navy are just gonna stand by? We ain't gonna win unless we are ready. Kobe was our ace in the hole. And you're telling me he got away? I'm sorry, Teach. Just hear me out. It ain't like I just let him scurry away. And they have a battleship, Sun Wolf, picking up buildings by hands and placing them down because they're all scattered around from Garp. Where does this shop go? To the left. Watch your ass, and his ass is crushing another building. And you let Moria escape too? Moria is alive as well. Commodore! Ready for anything. Everyone knows you're the man who'll claim the One Piece, Blackbeard. The one who's gonna take over the world. And all the pirates on the Pirate Island. Then we have all the Commodores. Zehahaha! Oh, I can try that better. Zehahaha! At least morale is on the rise. That's something we gotta take advantage of. Now, let me hear it, Kusan. Kobe got away. But, well, we caught Garp. Zehahaha! Now that's what I call a consolation prize. You keep finding a way to trade up, Captain. Yeah! Kusan going, he's clocking his glasses. To be honest, I was going for the kill, but he survived. Don't be hard on yourself, Kusan. There ain't many who can take him down, you know. Well, it was a team effort. Looks like the winds of fortune are favoring us. Wee ha ha ha! Jesus Burge. We also snagged this three-eyed girly here. Hey, get Lafitte on the line. We have pudding. Navy Umit Shipping HQ. Yes, Commodore Teach. What are those revolutionaries up to? Oh, this is Lafitte. Seems like their siege is proving effective, and the red port's bondolas keep breaking down whenever they try to load them with food. Nice. Let them starve. All supply shipments from foreign nations have been halted too. Even when the Navy managed to secure food, they can't stop the sabotage bondolas from crashing. The Celestial Dragons may really start to starve at this rate. It's all quite unprecedented, really. Not to mention engaging. Zehahaha! This ain't the time to sit back and watch. Get ready! Understood. Pirate Island. Pizarro, we've arrived! Nyan is the one! Oh! Oh my god. Kurubu? Oh my god. Oh my god. Caribou? Caribou. Caribou's on the ship. And he got details on the... Oh my god. Ancient weapons. He's gonna tell Teach about the ancient weapons. He's gonna tell him about Shirahoshi. I believe Teach is going to go to Wano. He's gonna use his tremor fruit and just smash the giant wall where the water is going down and open the world of country of Wano, like Shinichi was supposed to do. But he can do it with his fruit and then just eat up all the debris with the shadow fruit and darkness fruit. And then he's gonna get Pluton. And he's gonna get the red poneglyph. Pizarro, pick us up! You know, Pizarro with his giant hand, like island hand, just picking up the pirate ship. Docking you guys is always such a pain, yeah. You know I'm injured, right? Oh, the Caribou. Oh, hell no, it's monster. Don't take me. He's reacting to Pizarro. Oh, hell no, it's a monster. Don't take me. Big bro, big sis, save me. Quit your jabbering. You brought that guy, don't ya? Let me skip to the giants. It's been 2 days since the giant warrior pirates set off from Egghead. However, even with the sailing speed of the great Eirik, their ship is called Eirik. I'm from Norway, so I should know this. Eirik, Norway Viking. Oh my god, what is his name? In Norway we say Erik Thorvaldsson, and in English it's Erik the Red. He was a Norse explorer. He was one of the founding people who settled on Greenland. Or we can go to a lot of Eirik. Eirikir Håkonarsson, also known as Erik the... I don't know how to pronounce that. Erik of Haltir, or Erik of Norway, was Earl of Lade, Governor of Norway, and Earl of Northumbria. Northumbria? Where that is. It's in England. Northern part of England. But the ship is called Eirik. That's cool. They have yet to arrive at Elbaf. What could have caused this? What's going on? Did he pass out drunk? Where's the sun gone? I can't see it. And there's... besides the giant ship, there are two giant fish sailing past them. What is happening? Have the crew been split up again? We gotta find them. We can't head to Elbaf like this. Maybe they were swallowed by a fish? Quit it! The fish here are so massive that just might be true. Luffy, where did you go?
Nami, hey, wake up!
Nami just waking up from her hangover, I guess. Oh, I must have had too much to drink.
What?
Nami's just waking up inside a inside a Lego house? Why is she inside a Lego house? Everything is bricks. You have those bricks on the floor with dots on them. There you have Lego flowers. You have Lego arches. What is happening? So Nami and Luffy is been taken somewhere. Wait. Let's see whose crew is with them or not. Jimbe. Oh, that's cute. Jimbe is looking over the sea and Bonnie is just holding onto him with her thumb and her hand. Just nudging a little bit on him. Okay, so Jimbe, you have Robin, you have Frankie, you have Lilith, you have Brooke. That means Usopp, Sanji, Zoro, Nami, and Luffy are missing. And they are inside a Lego house. You have to see this to believe it. What is happening? Let me just make that. Hold on. You see this? Legos, Lego flower, Lego arches, Lego, Lego chandelier, Lego blocks, and her outfit. Oh my god. No break. It's next week. Okay, so they're inside a Lego mansion somehow. Someone has a Lego fruit. I did not expect that, but sure. Anything else out of notice just straight away? There are a lot of info going in this chapter and the last one. I'm sure to miss something that someone else is going to pick up on. Nothing I can see of special here. Nothing of special here. So Moira is alive and he escaped. So he might come back. I see in the picture on the pirate island, is there something? There's a giant parrot here in the air. I gotta see this. Sun wolf. My god. Look at him. He's placing buildings and crashing into other buildings. Oh, so funny. Bartos' crew is blown up. We don't know what happened to them. Chunk is laughing. We got to see Yasop in action. Just we probably get a more fleshed out version in the anime. You got to see Bartos' determination for Luffy drinking the potion, not poison, but it's fake, but still. Yeah, I don't see anything else out of the ordinary. That was a cool chapter. A lot of info, a lot of stuff happening. A lot of moving parts. I don't know why Lafitte is at the where the gondolas go up. Why is just chilling there? Are the Blackbeard pirates going? Well, he hasn't gotten the info from Caribou yet. But my what he's saying here is this ain't the time to sit back and watch. Get ready. So are they invading Murray Joe's? Is that their plan? I don't see how that's lucrative with all the forces on Murray Joe's. We have all the elders, Garling as well now. Emu, we don't know the power of Emu except that Emu can give powers and take them away and grant immortality. But I don't understand this Lego thing. Why are the Legos? When? How? they were sailing from Egghead to Elbaf, and they ended up in a Lego house. There gotta be something missing. So 2 days since the giant warrior pirates set off from Egghead. However, even with the sailing speed of the great Eirik, they have yet to arrive at Elbaf. What could have caused this? What's going on? Did we all pass out drunk? Where's the sunny gone? I can't see it. We gotta find them. We can't head to Elbaf like this. Maybe they were swallowed by a fish. Luffy, where did you go? There are giant ships, giant fish next to them. Sea kings, probably. A lot of them. And there's just a black panel. Nami, hey, wake up. And Nami's waking up inside the Lego house. But we don't see the other Straw Hat crews. What is happening? Alright, I don't know what to do here. Maybe I'll add something while I'm uploading or editing this video, if I edit it. Well, you know what? Actually, we'll just go to Reddit right now and see if there's someone talking about something interesting. Let's see. We go into this thread right here. People praising Barto. Rip the going Luffy Senpai. Putting all my money on them being in Prince Loki's Lego house. Yeah, that's someone pointed out that Lego is a Scandinavian company. More correctly, it's a Danish company. And the Danish people were the ruling Vikings in the Viking era. Or the king of Denmark took control of a lot of locations in both Scandinavia and in France and in England. Maybe is Loki's power. They were drinking absinthe, and absinthe make you hallucinate, they said. Let me just add that. they were. Oh, there are. Right. I'm gonna read the Reddit. If I come on, if I see something interesting and maybe I come up with something myself, I'll add it to this video. Yep. Thank you for watching. Leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye bye. Have a great day.